Welcome to Landria Onkka on YouTube, here to help you break through those fears and live an amazing life. I'm going to tell you something right now. You may not like it, but if you correct this, you could absolutely transform your entire life and shift into a completely different way of thinking that opens you up to the quantum field where everything flows, opportunities, joy, and the problems aren't such a big problem, right? Worry will dissolve. What is it? When you are worrying, you are not being grateful. All right, so I've done videos about this before. When you see a problem, it's because you are not liking the situation. You think it's not the way it should be, when you are actually the absolute source of why it's there. All right, you're creating it. It could be a collective thing too, but you're still creating it. How do we handle all of the problems, all of the worry, all of the doubt, all the stuff going on? When you feel that way, you are not being grateful. If you are grateful for absolutely everything that you have, no matter what's going on over here, you are now focused on what you have. When you are worried about something and upset and, you know, this isn't the way I want it to be, you are ungrateful. You are not thankful because you don't see that as an opportunity for positive change. You don't see that you've created it and that that is a message for you that things have to change. There's a different way for you to function. And so instead of seeing that as a gift, you're battling it. There's worry. You're in the ego. You're not grateful. Every single time we worry, when we have a problem, it's because we are not thankful for what we do have. And the message is lack, I don't have, things aren't the way I want it to be. That's it. Think about this. That is the message. Things are not the way I want them to be. Otherwise, you wouldn't worry. You wouldn't think it's a problem, right? You just go, okay, this is what it is. You wouldn't be worried. Maybe you'd be uncomfortable. Maybe we wouldn't like it so much. But the worry would dissolve because you would know that this too shall pass. This is just part of a, let's just say, evolution of your journey and things that need to be learned and you going on to new things. Now, we're going to talk more in 2020 about the expansion and what that means. I want you to get ready for this. This is all good. Expansion means shifts, big shifts. But if you do not go into grateful mode, you will still be battling everything that's happening, and you will be sending a message that I'm not grateful, I'm not in control, I lack, things are not the way I want them to be, ego, lower frequency. That's that message, that's all it is. Why would you ever be upset? If you had total faith and you things were gonna be okay, you would never be upset because you'd think, okay, well, at least I do have, a job, or at least I do have income, or at least I do have family, or at least I do have my health, or you would find the things that are right in your life and appreciate them so that you could maintain those and expand on them. So whatever you focus on expands. 2020, year of expansion and beyond. It's just going to keep going. Expanding, open. Why? Because we are opening up our minds and letting all the restrictions and self-doubt limitations go, which means we're sending that into the collective consciousness, which means we're sharing that thought. We're sharing that belief that anything's possible. So when anything's possible, you share in that collective of expansive thinking. When you put that thinking into it, you will experience it personally more yourself. Things are going to start to manifest like this. Why? Because the limitations are dissolving. We don't believe in them anymore. We're actually saying, okay, I do think that I'm really doing all of this. So when you're worrying and anything that has to do with a negative lower frequency, you're not feeling like you're controlling the situation, which means lack, not control. I'm not manifesting. I don't believe I'm doing all of this. I don't believe I can change it. I think there's something outside of me that needs to change it. I think I have to do something to get something or someone, infringing on free will, to do something for me because I want something. I get this all the time with relationships. How do I get that person to love me? wow, let's look at what's going on there, right? Why would you ever want that with somebody who doesn't want it? And if they want it, it'll happen. If you desire them, put it out to the universe, or better, right? Because maybe they're not the right person for you, and let it go. But that's the ego not being happy unless it gets what it wants. Lower frequency. Your message when you are grateful is, I have, I do have, and you will receive more. This is going to be a very difficult thing for most of you who are going through some big changes. You may not see what you have, but I'm going to guarantee you, every single person, no matter what you go through, has amazing things. Amazing things. So even when you go through the death, and we'll talk about all of that, if you guys know my story, when I quit investment banking, I lost my entire family. Boom, 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 right after another. Both of my pets, boom, boom, boom. One of my cousins, and all within a very short period of time, very quickly. These were not long drawn out illnesses or anything. You know, you could say that's great loss, or you could say that's life. We're all going to go in different ways. So when you grieve over something, it's for yourself, not them, because they're in an amazing place. The energy cannot be created nor destroyed. So when you start to look and say, wait, I can be grateful that person was in my life. I can be so grateful that they were in my life, right? And if you don't feel that way, that's okay, right? Don't beat yourself up. But when you're grateful and you say, wow, I had that amazing parent or that amazing pet, you know, and it's okay to be sad. But when you appreciate, when you say, I have so much, you'll start to really enjoy your life. You know, we get more and more and more, and then we are always upset because we want this and this and this and this, where we stop really loving and enjoying all the things we have. And I know myself, if I'm like looking to get to a certain place in whatever part of my life, I have to stop always and say, look at what you have. It's amazing. There's nothing you need. You have everything. And opening up to more opportunities and expansion is wonderful. And I allow the universe to do that. But we all have to reel ourselves back in sometimes and remind ourselves of just how much amazingness is around us in nature, in our pets that love us, in our health, and work on all of this. And if you don't have your health, why not? Is that what you're contributing to? Of course. And so work on that, because you were given a body and this amazing situation. And if you're not taking care of that, that's not being grateful either. This is huge, because gratitude and love are the two most powerful emotions and words that you can use. And when you feel love and gratitude, that is the most expansive feeling. And love and gratitude, that means giving and love, receiving and love. That's what you're giving. That you're putting that out, that's what you're going to receive. Love and gratitude, which means abundance. What gratitude means, I have. And then you receive, you start to receive all this stuff, and you go, oh, I have more. Oh my gosh, this is amazing. You start to receive more. And you give, you keep giving and giving. This is how it works. Focus on that for everything you're going through right now. You switch over to gratitude. You may not feel great. You may not feel like, oh, yay. You know, I just had this thing over here happen. Ow, this is painful. Yay, I'm supposed to be thankful. But yes, you can be. You can do this. You must do this to raise your frequency. It is required. Otherwise, you stay in the lower frequency of poor little me. Life shouldn't be happening to me this way. All right? You're not a poor little me. Everybody's going through stuff. And every time I hear a story, I go, well, get in line. You know, the entire planet has stuff that's either gone on or continues to go on, and we continue to be challenged, and it stinks. Nobody wants to keep being challenged. It's like, when do we get to that place where we just stop struggling and suffering? It's now, because it starts here and in here. And when you get these two working together, your world will change and the entire collective will change. So everybody within it is affected, and we will stop battling each other, pointing fingers. I'm so tired of the conspiracy and the disclosure. We don't need to know anything. We just need to work on this raising it and giving, giving, giving. Right? Because you'll be receiving like crazy. Stuff's going to show up and you're going to be thankful for it. Yeah. Oh my gosh. Yes. Thank you. Right? This morning I gave a gift next door to my neighbor on their porch. Within minutes, another friend texted me and said, I just left homemade soup on your door. That's how it works. Giving and receiving works. It's that simple. When you're all giving, you're all receiving. What an abundant, amazing world, and you're thankful. Thank you. Homemade soup, I get to eat homemade soup all day. Isn't that wonderful? You're whole and perfect. Come join me for my monthly webinar. January 18th is Activate Abundance. We're gonna talk about money. Why do we have a problem with abundance? Why is this a problem? We're gonna spend 3 hours talking about abundance. Why you struggle with money, why you struggle with receiving certain things. And that could even be relationships, because abundance includes everything in your life that you want to receive, that you desire. Is there something you consistently struggle with? I'll tell you right now what the issue is. We're going to work on it. If you miss January 18th and you don't participate, if you sign up, you will receive the recording and you can use it for a year. Everybody has a use for it for a year, which means 3 hours of us going through, you know, this, what's going on in the old head there, and then reversing it and handling it and having practices to deal with the blocks that continually put you back in the negative patterns and not receiving, right? Not receiving. So I have a problem and, you know, the world isn't the way it's supposed to. Why isn't this working? My manifesting isn't working. You just said that. You just created it. My manifesting isn't working. Well, I say everything I think I'm manifesting. So if you say you're not manifesting, it doesn't work, then you just blocked it. All right, so we're gonna move past that. So come join me, go to LandriaOnkka.com for all my spiritual, go to LandriaOnkka.net for all the tools, the training that has to do with money, learning new skills, internet training, all the things that could help get you out of jobs that you don't love and learning how to use the internet to earn money. And also I have coaching, mentoring, I've got all kinds of things on there. Go check them both out. Go expand, explore, come join me. I'm here to serve you. You're whole and perfect, strong and powerful, loving, harmonious and happy. Blessings to you, my friend. Namaste.